outings. He has started the last five and 13 of the last, or 14. It's in their home, blacks and the Oilers in their road, whites. Here comes Taylor Hall. It's got an angle, slides a pass over, went behind Dreisaitl. Cassian got it on net, and that gave Anderson time to move to his...
If it connects, boy, Freddie Anderson is out of his net, challenging. And you can see that pass does not arrive to Dreisaitl.
Able to win the puck over to Nate Thompson. Now Maroon on the half wall, throws it in front, off the stick of Sakara. Getzloff off the bench, gets to it. The captain into the slot, Nate Thompson's shot. Blocked on the way and then covered by Talbot.
Yeah.
With the extra man. Cam Fowler looks off, carries in, across to Perry. Getzloff whips it back to Fowler, tees it up, and a rebound that was there for a split second for David. And is Perry along with Raquel, but comes loose. Getzloff got a stick on it, open at the line. Was Fowler over to Lindholm. His shot bounces back to Getzloff, who settles it. Raquel finds an open Lindholm, had to settle it and can't get the shot away as it was by Anton Lander. Ducks bring it back in as the penalty winds down. The Bieksa's shot is held by Talbot, by Taylor Hall. In fact, Ryan Garvin's father was a goaltender in the Edmonton Oilers system and a longtime color analyst on their radio and television broadcast.
He's going to be a good guy.
By Fowler. Ducks again in the Edmonton zone. Kessler's pass to the far post intended. Swung back around as Darnell Nurse keeps an eye on Santarelli. Centers kicked right on goal by Getzloff, and Talbot to that. Kara leads at the up. Edmonton changing the Ducks with numbers. Here's Maroon. Leads it off to Bray. Back rebound, and Maroon's stick taken away by Brendan Davidson.
Oh, nice play. Here's the rush up ice for the Ducks. The 4-on-3 rush. The shot by Dupre. Fat rebound. Maroon thinks he's going to sweep it into a wide open net, but Davidson just got a piece of that stick.
Davidson's been
really improved. The personnel on the blue line, systems-wise, are much better this year.
Aaron passed through the middle, but Raquel got to it first. Bad angle shot to Talbot. Makes this property of the Ducks, who was claimed a month ago off waivers by the Oilers. And he keeps his man to the outside. Silverberg,
like big personnel decisions, trading top players in order to shore up the defense. It's going to have to be done. I mean, you can't just have just forwards.
There's Everly, and his shot partially blocked by
Gaines. Jakob Silverberg. That's a pretty good one. He gets a lot of the hands of Jordan Everly. The amount of contact.
Nate Thompson blocked that one-timer, and he is a little shaken up. Adam Clendenning's one-timer comes around, and now Davidson unable to rescue it.
People with speed moving away from the puck, surrounding it, and giving the puck carrier options. Good luck.
Cassian down low, works it out high, and here's Davidson. His shot got through. Anderson screened in front by Cassian, made the save. I'm not sure he ever saw it. It in. Cam runs it down on the far side. Had his stick taken away. Getzloff plays it along. The defender fell down. Ducks are 3-on-1. Here comes Getzloff. The exit joins the rush. Got it over. It's off his skate. And Talbot slides to his left. This leads it for Kessler, who chops it ahead. And now just 15 seconds to go as Clendenning weaves back, loses an edge, loses the puck. Silverberg got it on net on a quick feed from Cogliano. Pops into the slot again, and Cogliano, the one-time Oiler, chopped it over top of the net. Kessler sends it in front. Bouncing puck that Talbot pounces out on, again with Cogliano sniffing around.
It's all about the pressure from Kessler, Cogliano, and Silverberg, forcing turnovers, creating opportunities. An aggressive chip from them. You know, people talk about aggressiveness, and it's not always about, you know, hitting people. A lot of times it's about ramping up the pressure and speed and getting right in on top, forcing people to do something they don't want to do. Here was the bid by Jakob Silverberg. Nice little play, and Kessler just throws it blindly to the front of the net. And again, another good play by the...
On two into the Anaheim zone. Jean Kara's backhand, I think it was a pass across the top of the crease. Yakupov gets it from Sakara, and Anderson fights that off.
I'm running around a little bit, John, in the defensive zone here.
Flip to the net by Sakara, and again blocked away by Anderson. And joins the fray.
An exhausting shift for both teams.
point. Davidson gets it over to Osterley. A little rebound off of Anderson, and the Ducks find it first. Over the hash mark, gets there.
So look at the way he protects that puck.
The exit dusts it off and finds Kessler on the left side. A little saucer pass. Lindholm, quick shot. And that one's tipped into the netting above the high glass. And comes to Kessler. And Kessler wins it across for Hampus Lindholm. Pops into the middle of the ice, and Kessler whips it wide. Off the glass, Maroon pushes Bane off the puck, but he recovers possession. Ducks. Lindholm takes his feet up left wing and into the Edmonton zone. Back for Kessler, that's blocked by Pouliot. He's hurt. Raquel picks up the puck. Pouliot having trouble moving. Off the post from Raquel, that one hit the crossbar. Lindholm breaks his stick. And now Pouliot has his sea legs back, and the Oilers full strength.
Anaheim gets a couple of cracks. They hit one crossbar.
Getzlaf steams in, got it to Fowler, but he couldn't corral it. Cam had gotten a step on Tanner Hall. Perry turns, can't get it through. Into the slot, and Tanner Hall off to the races. Two on one as Kasson with him, gives it right back. Hall returns the favor. Anderson makes two saves as Osterley got to the rebound. The defenseman jumping up. 27th of January from the Anaheim Ducks off of waivers. Glendening never got a game with the Ducks after they got him in the deal from Pittsburgh that brought Perron over. Everly just missed off the wing. I don't know if Fowler got a piece of that or not. For Silverberg, a good job on the back checks by Jujar Kara. Kara has it behind the net. In front looking for Lander. It skips to Osterley. That's blocked. Down to get in front of that one was Jacob Silverberg.
We're seeing that second period when the change is so long.
Shots are 8-0 in the second period in favor of Edmonton. As Perron brings it across, pulls it in, and that's deflected. Fain got a piece of it. Botman rips it. Sticked away by Talbot. Andre Sequeira blocked four shots in the opening period. The Oilers are not a prolific shot-blocking team, but they're helping their goaltender out tonight. Botman, who had Anaheim's only goal in the win here on Wednesday against Buffalo, got it to Getzlaf. Nice little pass into the middle. Perron battling through a check to him, and McDavid has it pop out to him. Connor McDavid turns on the Jets into the Anaheim zone, drops it off, and gets it back from Pouliot. Put it in front, and Osterley, the defenseman, was all the way down on the doorstep again. Kessler gets back onside, redirects that feed in. It's Cogliano all over Davidson. Got it in front to Kessler. Backhand shoveled and blocked by Osterley. This brings it to center with Zach Kassian. Kassian lays it back. Fain lays it across. Sequeira let it go. Lays in front of Anderson. I don't think the initial shot even got through to him. Silverberg, a little out of control through the neutral zone as Fain got an angle on it. Silverberg has it again, nudges it ahead. Here's Kessler with Cogliano. Kessler just missed as he pulled it in on the forehand. Comes off the glass and out.
A little move, wasn't it? The way he tucked that puck back in, tried to snap it up into the top corner.
Manson feeds it in. Cogliano gets it to Lindholm, and that one is absorbed by Cam Talbot. Edmonton 1-8-1 in their last 10. The Ducks 8-1-1 in their last 10. And they're the backhander. From Josh Manson, Cam Talbot. With yet another stop as Maroon got it. This time it's Thompson's turn. He coughs it up. Maroon takes it behind the net. In front, Garvin turned away by Talbot.
Yeah, did not hit the target he was looking for.
Runs down a puck, lays it back to Davidson. His one-timer through traffic is wide. Osterley kicks it up the wall, gets it back, dusts it off. His shot off the skate of Lander and wide to the far corner. Game since coming over from Pittsburgh. Plus 14 in his last 15. That gave Anderson some problems from outside the blue line. The Oilers fan base. Kessler picks it up at his own line, makes a move, and it's into the Edmonton zone. Wanted to brush it over to Silverberg. Now he battles Sequeira, who gives it away to Cogliano, and stepping out, Talbot made the save.
Yeah, they're starting to. The physical play is starting to pay dividends. The Ducks sure watched that game last night against the Kings, and I thought when L.A. got physical in the second period, they just took over the game.
Everly's drive kicked away by Anderson. I don't think there was any doubt somewhat abused the Oilers after that opening period. They didn't turn away from any checks. Fowler protects the puck off the wall. Steps in. Oh, glances just wide. Good traffic in front as Nick Ritchie was blocking out the sun in front of Talbot. Santarelli. Over Raquel and Ritchie now down low with under a minute to go in the period, and Raquel protects the puck from Kara. Penalty coming up to the Oilers as a bad angle shot. Side pulls it back as now the power play is set up for David Perron. His shot blocked by Darnell Nurse. Nurse falls down as Perron gets it back. Open foul at the top of the left circle. His shot off a skate. Skips across to Getzlaf. 15 seconds in the period as the captain dusts it off. Botman moves it over. Fowler gives it back. Sammy winds. That's blocked. Hendricks got in the way of that. Fowler sends it to Perron. He gets it across. On the tee for Botman, just wide. 2 seconds left in the period, and Anaheim will have to carry over the power play time. Wins on the puck and gets around the test tube. Snaps a pass over for David Perron. He gets off. He storms right in front, trying to go high. Short side. And he scores. That one stuck up top.
This is a nice looking play because Getzlaf has momentum going towards the net when he accepts the pass. Here's the pass down low. Boy, quickly tucks it in around and smooth hands. Just kind of roots this one over the shoulder of Talbot, and the shot is perfect.
Back, Dreisaitl tries to protect, and as it pops across the zone, Kessler gets there. Kessler, a little bit of room through center, across the line with Maroon. Drifts to the board, back to Maroon on his backhand, right through the crease.
That's Garbutt again. Boy, Garbutt has had some chances in this game, hasn't he?
Here comes Everly, and he ties the game!
Jordan Everly stays hot, and this shot is perfect, up and over the glove. It's Pouliot, the playmaker this time. And the key is the crisp pass from Pouliot, and how nicely Jordan Everly was able to catch that pass and then snap that short little wrist shot over the glove hand of Freddie Anderson.
Straight up in the air, Garvin gloves it back down and moves it ahead to Raquel. Now he joins the rush, 3-on-2 of the Ducks.
Carrying the official time.
Oh, and that's fought off by Talbot.
That's a good stop by Cam Talbot.
Man out of Providence College brims it around into the Anaheim zone. It's chipped ahead, and here's Santarelli joined on the rush by Manson. The Ducks again, 3 abreast, hands it off. Raquel whips it. It's off the high glass and around, where Hendricks finally able to settle it. Backhand up the boards. Getzlaf takes it away from him at center. Across the line with David Perron. Sneaks it ahead. Here's Perron. Walks right in. Knocked off the stick. Rhythm shot. Panned away by Talbot. Out of the corner. Santarelli can't get his shot through Matt Hendricks. And he one-hands it into the Anaheim zone with both teams changing. The X are now forced to retreat as he's watched by Zach Cassian. Cassian came over mid-season from the Montreal Canadiens. And now he forces the X back again. Maroon can't go any further than center red and lays it back for Cam Fowler. Ducks regroup yet again. Fowler steps around Zach Cassian. Angles a stretch pass that Maroon
makes a nice play here. Watch this puck bounces up in the air. One hand knocks it out of the air. Tries to cut inside. It goes right to Hampus Lindholm. Boy.
Real problem for them. They gave up two last night to surrender a 1-0 lead against the Kings. Puck shot blocked off the stick of Sandra Helton. Comes back to Andre Sequeira and swings it down low, and Everly, the goal scorer, has it again. Looking for Pouliot in the high slot. Davidson throws it across. Cassian turns, his shot blocked by Sammy Botnin. Botnin knocked off balance, loses the puck. Cassian's shot blocked. Diving effort by Silverberg. Davidson has it. For Hall, his centering pass deflected. Bounces out to Nurse at the right point. And Kessler slaps that away. Ryan Kessler into the Edmonton zone, drops it. Silverberg on the blast, just wide. Rolled in front and off. Got center red, flipped it in. Oilers trying to change. He didn't get it deep. On the cross ice pass from Fowler is off. Gets off skate. Korpakoski denied by Perron, who steams into the Edmonton zone. Cuts in, backhander, Talbot stayed with it all the way and covers it up. Down low, Kuliak angles it off the wall. Penalty is over to Prey, comes out of the box, and the pass from McDavid comes right to it. He jumps out, lets it go, swatted away by Talbot. It's still laying in front of the Edmonton goal. Kept in by Davidson, slides it across. Thurst does sit off and misses on the short side.
Boy, that did not miss by much.
Clock. Anaheim captain gets it into the middle but couldn't connect with Garvin. Korpakoski winds it around into the Anaheim zone. Getzloff up the middle and Garvin is offside. And he shoots the puck.
The linesman should have blown the whistle.
It will not endear him.
And now they're going to send him all
hearts.
The way down. I mean, boy.
On the Eberle goal at 1:53 that tied the game. Ducks out of their own zone. A nice feed by Lindholm to Kessler in full flight into the middle. Silverberg fumbled it, got it back, and a glove save by Talbot.
He rips it right into the left hand of Cam Talbot. Jakob Silverberg, you know, when you spin around like that, you don't really know how much time you have. Puck comes back to him. All he's thinking is, I got to get this away in a hurry. You'll see that this is only about a foot and a half off the ice, so it's right in the catching glove of the goaltender. That's where they hold it, about that height.
The Frederick Anderson. 17 saves tonight for Anderson. Calling forward in front was Hendricks, and his stick lifted just as he tried to pull the trigger. Secker lets it go. Blocked by Ritchie. For the corner, Sakara gets it back. Covering his point is Letestu. Sakara brings it into the middle. This shot, waving at it with the glove, was Anderson.
Not sure whether he was going to go out and cover Richie's point or stay back.
Getzloff takes it into the Edmonton zone. In front, Santorelli can't connect.
Yeah, aerial pass just would not land.
Santorelli wins the puck out of the corner. And Perron on his backhand trying to get away from Hall. Snaps it across, Piexa, no traffic in front. It's blocked right to the high slot by Talbot. Perron whips it towards the goal. It's blocked. Got inside on Santorelli, and Taylor Hall at center lifts it into the Anaheim zone. Knocked down by Fowler, quickly ahead for Thompson, trying to catch the Oilers on a change, and that one's swatted down by Talbot. Can't get away from Kessler. Silverberg with it. Back for Kessler down low. Protects the puck from Ostrom. Drag to the front of the net, but Silverberg comes out high. Long wrist shot by Dupre, blocked out to Botnin. Anaheim won't let Edmonton have the puck. Cogliano has it knocked away, comes right to Botnin. He works below the goal line. Behind the net, Silverberg picks it up. Boy, everybody on the ice is tired now. Silverberg gets away from Osterley to the front of the net. Poke check by Talbot. Loose in the crease. And they get the whistle. I don't know if the puck was ever covered. In fact, it's along the boards behind the net. Lindholm to the line. Osterley has it knocked away by Getzloff, who got inside on it. Joining the rush is Perron. Getzloff. Careful. Rolls it right to the side of the net. A good read by Talbot with Hosen in the circle to the right of Frederick Anderson. Pouliot swings it behind the net, and Cogliano goes and gets it. 90 seconds in regulation as Cogliano speeds into the Edmonton zone. Wide on the wing, and Talbot denies that. It comes right back to Cogliano, puts it to the line for the Prey. Lander wins the draw. Osterley gives it to Fane. On the half wall, it's Leon Draisaitl into the middle, and Lander's shot blocked by Piexa. Pass ahead tipped in by Taylor Hall. Anderson stops it behind the net, plays it along, and that'll do it. We will go to overtime tonight at Honda Center. It's Silverberg, Fowler, and Kessler for the Ducks as McDavid picks it up and turns on the Jets. releases on the puck, and Fowler wisely plays the body. Anderson gave it right back to McDavid. It's not that big a deal to vacate the zone. You don't want to give up possession. To the bench gets lot, and Mikkel comes out.
As Raquel's going to come from behind and zip it right between the feet of Dreisaitl. He's got a forward back defending, and he beats him clean, and then he makes it look easy against Talbot.